In this guide, we are going to learn the fastest, safest, efficient, insta-killing and most importantly the earliest available ways of destroying the player cards in all the difficulties. Let's get to the science. Let's start with the fastest ways of destroying the player cards. Since lethal zone hearts are different than other difficulties, there have to be two fastest methods. Number 1. The ultra-fast guns. If the action difficulty is set to nightmare zone and below, the play cards can be destroyed in just under 2 seconds with Spec Ops Vector SMG or G18 Auto Custom when they are equipped with advanced brakes. These are the fastest guns in the entire game. But guns don't make for the fastest way in lethal zone because lethal zone hearts are twice as strong as nightmare zone hearts, so guns needed a minimum of 5 seconds to destroy them. But if you wanted to destroy the lethal zone hearts the fastest way possible using guns, you can carry both Spec Ops Vector and G18 Auto Custom. Empty the clip of Spec Ops Vector first, switch guns and then fire G18 Auto Custom. Number 2. The Bloater Cloud Grenades. Since lethal zone hearts are very strong, the fastest way of destroying them will be using the most powerful explosive, which is Bloater Cloud Grenades. Only 3 gas grenades are enough to destroy a lethal zone heart, which can be done just under 4 seconds. Only use road flares to ignite the gas for consistent results because different igniters will give us different results. Use the timestamps to find the playcard exclusive datasheets to learn how much health playcards have and how many resources we exactly need to destroy them in all the difficulties. Now let's move to the insta-killing tricks. A very important mistake most of the players are doing is using multiple explosives at the same time thinking they will insta-kill a playcard. But the damage of explosives will not stack against hearts when multiples of them are used at the same time. So explosives must be used one at a time against playcards. Number 1. The Bloater Cloud Grenades. If the action difficulty is set to dread or below, a single gas grenade can insta-kill a playcard. Number 2. The C4 stacking trick. Multiple explosive damages will not stack against playcards, but if the game is set to nightmare zone and below, I have an exclusive C4 stacking trick which can be used to insta-kill the playcards. When we load into our community, none of the hearts can be insta-killed with multiple C4 charges. But if we hit any one zombie with any one explosive or an incendiary, all the hearts will lose their immunity to the stacked C4 charges. So we can insta-kill the nightmare zone and lower level hearts by detonating 2 C4 charges at once. When we quit the game or exit to the main menu, all the play hearts will again become immune to the stacked C4 charges. So every time we load into a community, we must hit any one zombie with any one explosive or an incendiary to make the plague heart susceptible to the stacked C4 charges in that session. This trick is exclusive to the C4 charges and will not work for other explosives. Also, this trick will not work in the lethal zone. Number 3. The C4 stacking trick version 2. If the previous C4 stacking trick is not working reliable for you, I have another C4 stacking trick for Nightmare Zone and below. When we place a C4 charge, it will have an arming time of approximately 2 seconds, so we can use that to our advantage. Once we set up our first C4 charge, take time, move away from it, set up the second charge and immediately detonate the first one before the second charge is armed. So the second charge will be intact and we can press the trigger again to kill the heart. Keep in mind that the explosives don't need to be detonated closer to the hearts. As long as the plague hearts are inside the blasting radius, they will receive full damage delivered by the explosives. Placing a C4 charge here makes absolutely zero difference. Even in the lethal zone, we can use this trick to stack 2 C4 charges against the lethal zone hearts. First phase of the plague hearts is the healthiest, so we can detonate a single charge first to avoid the plague heart bleeding and then use this trick to stack 2 charges at the same time.
It's hurting, don't let up now! I'm calling this plague heart history!
Number 4. The C4 stacking trick version 3. If we detonate multiple C4 charges at the same time against a lethal heart, The heart will consider all those explosions as a single one, so the explosives will not stack against them. Interestingly, when you detonate multiple remote explosives at the same time, you might have noticed that the explosives will not go off at the same time. They will go off by the order we planted them. So we can use that to create a delayed explosion between 3 C4 charges and make them insta-kill the lethal zone play cards. To create a delayed explosion between 3 C4 charges, we should remove 4 charges between each pair to create a sufficient time delay. This means these time filler C4 charges should be planted away from the play cards. But the problem is, using 8 C4 charges as time fillers is very expensive. So we must use cheaper remotely activating items as fillers to be cost effective. The boombox decoys are the cheapest I can find, and since they don't explode, they don't need to be planted away from the play cards. So if we plant 4 boombox decoys between each C4 charge, they will create sufficient time delay between each charge to make 3 C4 charges stack against the lethal zone hearts. This trick is still expensive even with the decoy fillers, but this will be the only way of stacking 3 C4 charges against the lethal zone play cards. And it will definitely be a fun way of destroying the play cards in our long-term communities. Number 5. The deployable pyro minefields. We never consider clear explosives because they are expensive to make, but if we have a lot of prestige points, we can buy them from the prestige traders. Most of the clear explosives are weak against play cards, but the deployable pyro minefield is very powerful and is capable of insta-killing a lethal zone heart. Each pyro minefield will deploy 12 pyro mines around it, and only 10 mines are enough to destroy a lethal zone heart. But the trick is, the minefield must be placed in a spot where most of the deployed mines hit the play card. It has to be placed exactly in between the wall and the play card to make the most out of the minefield. But only very few hearts allow us to place the minefield exactly in between the wall and themselves. So one pyro minefield won't be enough for most of the lethal zone hearts. That's why we have to pair the pyro minefield with a regular minefield. We should place both the minefields in the closest possible spot between the wall and the play heart. Then we can leave the area and detonate them from a safe distance and watch the play heart dying. For the nightmare zone and below, only the pyro minefield will be more than enough. When setting up the minefields, do not place them while moving. There is a bug in the game that will teleport the placed explosives few meters away if we are placing them while moving, so stay still while planting the minefields. Also, when the minefields do not kill the play card immediately, just stay there for half a minute because the confused zombies will trigger the remaining mines, which may destroy the play card.
This plague heart is history.
Number 6. The artillery strikes. If we have an artillery outpost, the artillery strikes are capable of insta-killing a lethal zone heart. But it has a huge limitation. Artillery strikes are not capable of delivering the damage through the walls, so it can only be used against the open play cards, which are extremely rare. So artillery strikes are useless most of the time. Number 7. The drone strikes. If we have a programming specialist, we will have the ability to call drone strikes from our level 3 command center. The unique ability of drone strikes is that it is the only explosion in the entire game that is capable of delivering the damage through the walls. Also, this explosion has the biggest blasting radius in the entire game. This explosion is so powerful that it can insta-kill a nightmare zone heart and is capable of taking out 83% health of a lethal zone heart. So to insta-kill a lethal zone heart, set up a C4 charge inside and call the drone strike outside where the play heart is located closest to the wall. Once the drone strike arrived, we can detonate the C4 charge to kill the lethal heart. Since the blasting radius of drone strike is very big, we don't need to drop the smoke closer to the wall. Once we drop the smoke, we should flee the area immediately because the smoke will attract all the nearby zombies to that area. The only limitation of the drone strikes is that it cannot be used against the hearts that are located in the center of a building because the blast radius may not reach the center. Now let's move to the safest ways of destroying the player hearts. In the following safest methods, it is optional to consume synth block for the enhanced safety of our characters. It is just player's preference. Also, always follow the house clearing protocol and the critical car parking tricks to destroy the player hearts safer and easier. Number 1. The fastest ways. Up to Nightmare Zone, the fastest way we already saw will also be one of the safest ways because it can be done just under 2 seconds and the destruction of a player heart will also eliminate all the plague zombies around it. So it'll be very safe. We only need to kill the feral that spawns to protect the heart. Number 2. The insta-killing tricks. All the above in insta-killing tricks can be executed in the safest way possible if we follow the critical parking tricks and the house clearing protocol.
The plague heart is gone.
Number 3. Standing on top of the cars. Most of the plague hearts are visible from outside the building, so we can park our car using the critical parking tricks and destroy the plague heart while standing on top of our car. We can use any available methods such as guns, explosives or incendiaries. Once the heart is destroyed, kill the feral with our spiked car or with a gun. Lure the remaining zombies away and get back to the car to kill all of them. Number 4. The smoke grenades. Smoke grenades are one of the most ignored items in the game, but actually they are better than even the scent blocks. Scent blocks do not make us completely invisible from the zombies, but the smoke grenades can completely blind even the blood ferals inside the smoke cloud. But if we throw a smoke grenade on a heart, the radius of the smoke cloud may not be wide enough to safely hide inside when the player heart releases gas. That's why we should always throw the smoke grenades to the side of the player hearts. Then we will have the whole diameter of the smoke cloud to safely hide inside. With smoke grenades and a heavy weapon, get close to the player heart, throw a smoke grenade to the side and start attacking once our stamina is full. Our character skill doesn't matter and we don't even need any stamina consumables.
I need a rest.
When the player heart releases gas, don't panic and get back a little until the gas clears. When the smoke is clearing, immediately throw another smoke grenade to the side. So with smoke grenades, we can safely destroy the lethal zone hearts even while being surrounded by multiple zombies and ferals. Only heavy weapons are recommended because they are the time-efficient melee weapons against player hearts. Once the player heart is destroyed, refill the stamina inside the smoke cloud before escaping. Keep in mind that we should always aim and then throw the grenades to get accurate results. But since there will be a lot of plague zombies inside, we can lure them out first to buy us a little time to accurately throw our first grenade without any rush. Throwing the second and the third grenades will not be a problem because we will already be safely hiding inside the smoke cloud. Number 5. The cheesy play cards. There are two types of cheesy play cards. One will only have one entrance, so we can block it with our car and destroy the heart safely from inside the building. The other will allow us to drive directly up to them so we can stand on top of our cars and melee them to the death. Some cars allow us to get inside while standing on the hood, so we can use the trick to escape from the zombies in the second category play cards. The following are the locations of the cheesy play cards. In the first category, we have the barn, the shipping containers, the chemical sheds which are exclusive to Trumbull Valley, and the garage that is near the Trumbull Valley landmark outpost. In the second category, we have the barn, the auto repair shops, the medical tents, and finally the cylinder-shaped warehouses that are only present in Drucker and Cascade Hills.
I taste blood in my mouth. This could
Number 6. The Silent Killing. Echo X2 Sniper is the most powerful crossbow, and with it, we can silently destroy a lethal zone heart just with 58 bolts. It takes a lot of time, but no zombie will ever know who is attacking the player cart. We can crouch in front of our car to hide from the zombies that are behind us. Now let's move to the efficient ways of destroying the player carts. Number 1. The Bloater Cloud Grenades. Bloater cloud grenades are cheap to make, so not only they are fast, but also efficient. Number 2. The Heavy Weapons. It is no doubt that using melee weapons is a super efficient way of destroying the player carts. And heavy weapons are the best way to do that because they are the time efficient melee weapons. If we have powerhouse cardio specialization, we can power swing the heavy weapons, which will allow us to destroy the lethal zone hearts with less than 9 hits. We can use scent block or smoke grenades to make the melee killing easier while being efficient. Number 3. The Air Strikes. The drone strikes and the artillery strikes only cost influence to call them, so they are very efficient. Also, we can use only the drone strike to instantly weaken the lethal player hearts and come back later to easily take care of the remaining 17% health of the hearts. Number 4. The Cheesy Player Hearts. The cheesy player hearts are the most efficient because we can destroy them just with kicks without worrying about any zombies. Now we have come to the most important section of this video. The earliest available ways of destroying the player hearts. Most of the above methods can only be used in the well-established communities, so they will be useless when we are starting a fresh community. The following methods are best suitable for lethal zone, but if they work in the lethal zone, they will also work in the other difficulties. Number 1. The Cheesy Hearts. It is obvious that the cheesy hearts can be destroyed the moment we start a fresh game because they absolutely need no weapon and it is extremely safe. Number 2. The Heavy Weapons and Stimulants. Once we get a heavy weapon and a few bottles of stimulants, we will be ready to destroy a player heart. Stimulants can be acquired primarily by destroying the player hearts. New recruits also will often have few bottles in their inventory. So if we don't have any, we can destroy the cheesy player hearts first to get a few of them. With a heavy weapon and stimulants, we can rush inside a player heart building, consume a stimulant and start attacking the heart. When the zombies get closer, we can dodge back and forth to deliver the attacks. When there are too many, we can dodge back further to lure the zombies away and then deliver the attacks. The most important part of this trick is that we should have the ability to quickly kill the ferals, because a feral will spawn most of the time the moment we attack a player heart in the harder difficulties. Spiked cars, gunslinging and powerhouse dropkick are the quickest and reliable ways to kill a blood feral in an early game. We can also climb our cars to get the high ground advantage. So when a feral spawns, we can rush outside to kill it quickly and get back to destroy the player heart. Number 3. The Heavy Weapon Without Stimulants. Sometimes, the stimulants and the quick feral killing methods will not be available in our fresh communities. Even in those cases, we can safely destroy the player cards only using a heavy weapon. Follow the house clearing protocol, park the car using the critical parking tricks and get close to the heart. Once our stamina is full, we can start attacking the player card. First phase of the player cards is the longest, so we most of the time won't be able to take out the first phase before the feral gets close. When the feral gets close, or when the player card releases gas, rush back to the car and kill all the zombies by reversing onto them. Then we can come back and attack the player card again. The second and the third phases are short, so we can take them out before any zombies get close. But the strategy here is, we should get back to the car when the player cart releases gas or when the blood feral gets close. If we follow this, we can destroy the lethal player carts without taking a single hit. And if we already have the powerhouse skill, we can power swing the heavy weapon to be time and stamina efficient.
That can barely swing this thing.
Keep in mind that the damaged plague hearts will release a pulse every 30 seconds that will spawn 3 plague zombies, which may include a blood feral. So we should be careful about that. Number 4. The fresh game advantage. The zombie spawn rate will be at its lowest when we are starting a fresh game, so if we attack the plague hearts in a very fresh game, no blood feral will spawn, but only few zombies will spawn to protect the heart. We can simply follow the third trick in a very fresh game to clear the plague hearts that have climbed our target base. Material sites are the quickest way of finding a heavy weapon, but if we start the game in Providence Ridge, the map has a secret heavy weapon location which we can take advantage of. And the ultimate trade-off of this trick will be the increased community standing, so we might be seeing bigger zombie hordes within a day or two. But since plague hearts don't regenerate their health, we can take out 90% health of our target plague hearts and leave them until our community is ready for our target base to keep our standing low. Second phase of a plague heart is the shortest, so in the third phase, if we deliver the same amount of hits we did in the second phase, the plague heart will approximately lose 90% of its health. Since we only need a heavy weapon and a few bags of snacks, we can only bring these two items to be lightweight so we can be more stamina efficient. Number 5. The deployable pyro minefields. If you have unlocked the pyro minefields, you can buy them from the prestige traders in your fresh communities and use them to insta-kill the lethal plague hearts.
That plague heart is history.
Number 6. The Trumbull Valley Landmark. Trumbull Valley Landmark Outpost allows us to craft the bloater cloud grenades, so if we climb the landmark outpost, we will have access to the fastest and one of the efficient ways of destroying the plague hearts in an early game. Most importantly, road flares must be used to ignite the gas for consistent results, and they can easily be found in the early games. Number 7. The smoke grenades. We already know how effective the smoke grenades are against plague hearts, and they can be found in the early games, which makes destroying the lethal zone hearts extremely easy and efficient. Most importantly, if we move to the rural police station, the police armory will have the option to craft smoke grenades for a cheap price, which makes destroying the lethal zone hearts insanely easier.
One more plague heart off the list.
Number 8. The C4 chargers. C4 chargers are cheap to make, but the only problem of making them in a fresh community will be finding enough scraps of circuitries. But if we got enough circuitries and the knowledge is required, C4 chargers will make the job very easy. In Lethal Zone, we can detonate 3 C4 chargers one after another to easily destroy the plague hearts in an early game. An energy drink will make the job so much easier because if we keep dodging, no zombie can catch us. Now we must learn the critical parking tricks. When parking the cars, always park them against walls and other objects to prevent the zombies from latching onto the engine. And when escaping, always get in from the right side of the car so the zombies will prioritize grabbing the right door instead of the most important left door. Getting in from the right side is actually more important than you think. Also, if any building has inward right angle structure, that should be our parking spot, because if we park our car blocking both the front and the left, we will be invincible inside our car until a bloater or juggernaut show up. Zombies latching onto the back do absolutely zero damage to our cars. Most importantly, the game offers 3 invincible cars: the Impaler, Z-Buster and the Utility Truck. These cars only ask you to block their left side because they do not allow the zombies to latch onto their engines. So these cars make us invincible wherever we go. Up next is the house clearing protocol. To make a plague heart building safer, all the zombies inside and around the building must be killed so no new zombie will spawn inside the building. Keep in mind that in the harder difficulties, the zombies inside a building will only spawn when we get very close to the building. So before starting clearing the zombies, park the car using the critical parking tricks, rush inside the building to spawn the zombies inside and get back to the car immediately. Then we can lure all the zombies by honking and kill them by reversing onto them. If we do this, the Playheart building will be completely safe for us to execute whatever the trick we are planning. Finally, here are the rankings of all the tricks we saw in this video. So it will be easy for you to pick up your favorite method. Also, all the unedited tricks from this video are compiled into a different video, so check that as well if you are interested. Here are the data charts. You can pause the video to take screenshots or join my Discord server to get them along with other exclusive charts. And finally, click here to learn why the watchtowers will get your community killed. Click here for the Lethal Zone Beginner's Guide and click here for the Cheesy Lethal Zone Guide. We'll see you in the next video.